Hey guys, I'm Winter Droid and welcome. Today, we fight the final gym leader. I trained all my Pokemon to level 47, OG Clam to level 48. Off screen, I ran over and grabbed the HM for Rock Smash, which we will be needing next time. Sorry, I didn't see what this guy said. Yo, champ in the making, even I don't know the Viridian leader's identity. One thing certain, this will be the toughest of all the gym leaders. Also, I heard that the trainers here like ground-type Pokemon. So, this is a ground-type gym with a sliding floor puzzle. Let's just fight all the trainers, see what we're dealing with, see what we gotta go up against. Heh, you must be running out of steam by now. Cool trainer, Yuji. Mary Jane learned Petal Dance, which is a pretty good move. It's kinda like a lot like Outrage. A dragon type move. It basically locks you into this move. It's all you can do. You can't switch out or anything. And after about 3 turns, it confuses you, which is kind of sucky. But I'm thinking I can just switch out of Mary Jane and back to OG Clam, who I know I can always rely on. Use an absorb, and I don't know why I did that at all. Little dance, do the job. And I just realized I had 2 TMs that I think I'm gonna teach. Actually, no, I should teach Sunny Day to someone, but not Mary Jane. Who has a move that we can just get rid of? I don't really know. Everybody's got pretty solid movesets. Whatever, I'll just teach it to Mary Jane in place of, Absorb. Sunny Day, and we also have Solar Beam, which you definitely want. That is just gonna be amazing on you. Get rid of Sleep Powder, sadly, but it's all worth it in the end, because you are learning one of the strongest, well, one of the strongest grass type moves in the game. So we'll start out with a Sunny Day. Let's test out our Solar Beam. One shot kill, of course, on these guys that aren't even ground type or rock type. Well, that was a crit, so. Was his name Asushi? Pokemon and I, we make wonderful music together. Even though that is a tamer and not a musician. You are in perfect harmony. And this place has some pretty mixed trainer classes. They got tamers, they have that other thing, and they got these cool trainers who have purple hair, which, might I add, is definitely cool. Purple hair is in. Mary Jane is getting the levels. And the Nidorina, and of course now we're confused. But I have full faith in Mary Jane to not hurt herself. Never mind, I'm wrong twice. And, oh, he didn't use, I could have sworn we used Sunny Day. We're switching out to OG Clam. We're using a Surf. I could have used Aurora Beam, would have been super effective. But, doesn't kill. Spike Cannon. Bouse. Let's use some super potions. All better. I'm the Karate King. Your fate rests with me. Black belt Takasashi. Well, that's a mouthful. Sunny Day taking some sunlight. And fire a solar beam. And a Machop. We can Petal Dance, I guess. Finish that thing off. Machoke might not die in one Petal Dance. Oh, well, we get a crit, so that's very helpful, most definitely. And let's head up here. But now our leader is back. Let's use a Petal Dance. like OG Clam is just a beast against these ground and rock type Pokemon. Super effective with water type, super effective with ice type. I think it's just a complete monster. Alright, please go down. Die, Nidorino. There he is, the gym leader. And the gym leader of the Viridian City Gym. Is that who I think it is? Vwaha! Welcome to my hideout. It shall be so until I can restore Team Rocket to its former glory. But you have found me again. So be it. This time, I'm not holding back. Once more, you shall face Giovanni, the greatest trainer. And that we will. Here it is, the final gym battle. Before we take on the Elite Four against Leader Giovanni. The leader of Team Rocket is actually the leader of the final gym. That is just like mind blown right there. That is just amazing. It's like such a plot twist. Like when you're a kid and that happens, it's like, what? No, that can't happen. He's evil. Gym leaders are good. But it happened. And here's his Rhyhorn level 50. That's his strongest Pokemon. Don't know why he's sending it out second. But we killed him in one hit, so it's not important. And here comes Nidoqueen. Probably should have used Aurora Beam, but super effective nonetheless. One-shot kill nonetheless. And a Nidoking level 45. If I were him, I would have had my Nidoking be level 45. Or at least evolve the Rhyhorn into a Rhydon. I mean, come on. Got that thing in one shot. And last but certainly not least, actually, certainly least, it's his weakest Pokemon, is a Dugtrio. And he uses an Earthquake. Ouch. Just kidding. That did like 19 damage. One of the strongest moves in the game. And there we have it. Ha! That was a truly intense fight. You have won. As proof, here is the Earth Badge. We finally did it. We got all 8 Pokemon League Gym Badges. The Earth Badge makes Pokemon of any level obey without question. It is evidence of your mastery as a Pokemon trainer. With it, you can challenge the Pokemon League. Also, take this TM. Consider it a gift. And we get TM26 contains Earthquake. It is a powerful attack that causes a massive tremor. I made it when I ran the gym here, far too long ago. And yeah, that's it. Final gym. It's over. Giovanni is defeated for the last time. We have finally done it. We have defeated all of the gyms in Kanto. But we still have the Pokemon League before us. And before that, we have something else. 3 things. Fire, ice, and electricity. And next time, we will discover them. See you all then.